Which actually leads to a very important cultural danger. In making things up, you're nevertheless writing a book about a whole culture and a whole place. So whoever reads this, even though you wrote this book, is going to say, you didn't get it right, you didn't get it right. Where do you draw that line between what you feel free to make up and the allegiance you have to a truth as you have researched it or perceive it to be or remember it to be?
Yeah, that was actually a tricky one, and I thought about that a lot. And you know, so many authors get told that they got something wrong, or and then of course how important that is depends on them and their readers. But you know, this is about Iran, and so I expect some people will say, well, you didn't get this or that right. I did a tremendous amount of research, and I had this run by so many readers from the region, including a very delightful scholar of Gilan, who is a Frenchman who's retired to the south of France, and he read the book and picked out every tiny thing. But there's
about
some
Iran.
Things well about Gilan, the region, yes.
Okay.
And there are some things though that I chose to keep in the story that I knew weren't necessarily, you know, perfectly correct, and because I chose to prioritize a story over that particular kind of accuracy. So for example, I wanted to set my story in the north of Iran. It was that was important to me and to the plot, as you know. But you know, I also, because it's about storytelling, I wanted to have the kursi, you know, the Persian structure where it's a low table with a blanket over it, and underneath is a stove, and people put their feet under and they tell stories. The thing,
you know, can you elaborate on that a little bit? Because that was such a wonderful. It occurs all the way through the book.
Yeah,
and it's the sofre.
Oh no, the kursi. The sofre is a cloth that you eat on the floor.
Okay.
But the kursi is a low table, and underneath is a stove, and there's a big thick blanket thrown over it, and everyone puts their feet under, and then you know, you get warm and cozy, and you're covered with blankets, and then you drink tea and or smoke a hookah or eat, and you tell stories around the kursi. The thing is though that you wouldn't see a kursi so much in the north because of the climate.
I
put that in the author's note. That was a moment where I decided to just use a detail from my own childhood.
Which I think you're wise to do. This is a not a cultural history. Ultimately, it's a story of a human being.
Yes.
You know, and whatever the vagaries of being a human. As humans, we don't ever get it all right.
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly.
So I think there's plenty to go on that.